Hi everyone, it's Ken LaRue once again with a tip of the day in our 30 tips in 30 days. I'm focusing on RV again in this video, and I'm going to look at a lot of the viewport controls you have. Everything from zooming in and zooming out and panning, and also adding color correction directly in the viewport, which is a very powerful part of RV's workflow. So let's start and take a look at this. You can zoom in and out of your frame by using your number keys, either above your letters or from the keypad. Using 1 brings you to scale of 1 to 1. 2 is going to zoom you in 2 to 1. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. I'll click 1 again to bring me back to 1 to 1. Hold the control key on Windows or Linux or the command key on the Mac and you start to scale in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can manually zoom in on your image by clicking and dragging when you're holding a modifier key. That key on Windows and Linux is the control key. On the Mac, it's the command key. So I'm going to hold down the command key, and I click and I drag, and now I can zoom in. And the viewer is going to zoom in to whatever pixel I am originally clicking on and dragging on. All right, and then we can reset the zoom factor to fit by hitting the F key. If you want to pan your image around, you can hold the Alt key on Windows and Linux or the Option key on the Mac, and then again, I can click and drag. Now I can pan my image around. So using my Command, I can zoom in, and using my Option, I can click and drag to pan this around. Once again, I'll hit the F key, which will fit the image back to its original size for my frame. You can also flop and flip your image inside the player. If I hold the Shift key and I hit the X key, I flop the image. Shift key, X, once again, I flop it back to its original position. Shift and Y is going to flip your image. So now I can hit Shift Y again and flip it back to its original orientation. Along the top here, you've got a couple different options as far as what color information or channels is going to be displayed inside the player. If I hit the R key, I'm now looking at the red channel. I hit the G key, we're now looking at the green channel. Hit the B key, we're now looking at the blue channel. Hit the C key, you go back to looking at your color display. If I hit the L key, I'm going to look at the luminance display. If you hit the A key, you'll look at the alpha. I do not have any alpha on this clip, so that's why we see no alpha. I'll hit the C key to return back to the color display. So those are all available from this flyout or just using the hotkeys. If you want to interactively adjust the gamma, the exposure, saturation, the hue, or the contrast, you can do so by going to the color menu and choosing any one of the interactive edit modes or use any of the hotkeys. So for example, the gamma is Y. Now, if I click and drag in the viewport, I am adjusting the gamma interactively inside the viewport. When I release the cursor, we step out of the interactive gamma mode. If I hit the E key, I enter into the edit exposure. Now I click and drag, I can edit the exposure of this clip by clicking and dragging left to right. And again, once I release the cursor, we'll exit out of that mode. To interactively adjust the saturation, hold Shift and hit the S key. Now I can increase and decrease the saturation. Hitting the H key, I enter into the Edit Hue control. Again, just click and drag inside the viewport. Lastly is the contrast. I hit the K key, I enter the interactive contrast edit. And now I can do the same thing as I was doing before. By clicking left and right, I can adjust the contrast. Holding the Shift key and hitting your Home key will reset everything that you've just adjusted. It brings it back to the original default saturation, hue, contrast, and so on. So in this video, we've actually covered quite a few tips. We looked at the different zooming and panning options you have. We looked at how you can display different colored channels and information in the viewport. And then finally, we looked at the interactive adjustments you can make to the different color information for your images. So that's it. This was it. The last tip. 30 tips in 30 days, and this is the last one. I really hope that you've enjoyed them. I hope that you have learned a lot from them and remember to revisit them as needed. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you later. 30 tips in 30 days.